Hi and good morning, and today in this video we'll be learning about Nginx, WSGI, payload balancing and Redis, everything in a Docker container. So let's get some coffee. I already have my coffee here. And now let's get started with coding. So that's my workstation.
I am back on my computer and let's get started. Here you can see, I'm gonna be going from scratch and trying to explain you the file structure. Let me close everything up. I don't wanna confuse you. So here is the file structure. I have three folders: Flask, Nginx, Redis, and on the outer directory, I have a docker-compose.yaml file, right? So let me adjust my computer. That's fine. So now, if I go to the Flask, I have like the run.py, which is basically a hello world file. And remember, I'm also using the Redis here. So basically, if you observe very, very carefully, I'm not using localhost or production IP. So you have to say Redis here. If you are using Docker containers, if they want to talk to each other, that's what you would do, okay? I have a test script, basically, which basically checks whether in my unit test video, I discussed about this. Basically, this checks the status code if it is 200, this checks the application if it's returning JSON, and this checks the message. So that's the test code. We have a requirements.txt, so basically all the Flask module and Redis libraries that we need to be installed. Then we have app.ini. So basically what app.ini does is basically we say WSGI, we're gonna run run.py file, call app, callable is app, right? Then we say, sorry for that. So socket is 8080. So basically it's gonna be listening on the 8080. So basically Nginx port is gonna be triggering WSGI on 8080 and processes. So we're gonna create multiple processes of our Python application or the REST API running on different ports. Threads 2, master true, socket 660, vacuum true, and die on terms as true, okay? So pretty simple stuff right here. Let's move to the Docker file. Step one, we basically use the Alpine operating system. Basically step two, three, and four. Basically step two is basically we install the dependencies. Step three, we basically create a work directory on an Alpine operating system. Step four, we copy all the project files on the app directory. Step five, basically some Linux distribution. Basically we need to install all of these. And step six, we run the WSGI command app.ini. This is gonna create our Flask REST API, creates multiple instances of a Flask API running on port one, port two, port three, port four. This is giving you an example, okay? That's the Flask. Let's look at the Nginx. So we have a Docker file here. So from Nginx, run, remove the configuration, default configuration, and add the configuration that I am giving to you. And this is the configuration that I am giving to you. Server, we define a server. Then we say listen to port 80, and then we say location. When anyone comes to the default route, that is the home route, include WSGI parameters, WSGI pass flask 8080. So this is gonna basically pass to the flask, gonna go to the 8080. So it's gonna go to the app.ini 8080. It's gonna create multiple instance and then basically route it accordingly. So that is what the Nginx file is doing. Let's look at the Redis. Docker-compose.yaml file. So the very first thing, version 3.7, I'm defining my services. So I say build the Flask application, container name should be Flask, restart always if anything fails. This depends on Redis, so this you have to say, this has a dependency on Redis. Expose port 8080, because Flask is gonna listen on port 8080, and internally it's gonna create all the processes and gonna redirect your traffic. Then we say Nginx equals to build Nginx. So this is gonna go to the Nginx folder and go to the Docker file and build everything. Sorry for the background music, the neighborhood. container name as Nginx, right? And then again, I'm saying restart as always and port as 8080. So this means that expose port 8080 to the outside world. So I'll be using whenever with anyone goes to the production IP or the local host IP, it will be redirected basically to the HTTP port. It's gonna redirect to 8080 and internal, it's gonna do the Flask. And then we say Redis, image as Redis. So this is the entire setup that you would basically be doing. So now if I want to basically, so I can say when come to the outer directory. Now say if you're using a Windows, do dir. If you're using a Mac, do ls. And say docker compose Basically, we would say Docker compose and type in a command called as build. So this is gonna build a Redis and all of that together. So if you observe in my Flask app, in my basic get route, okay, so it's done already. So basically, if you observe, I'm trying to connect to it. If Redis is connected, it's gonna print the message as okay. Otherwise, it's gonna say failed. Okay. So whenever I hit the foo route, so the Redis also should work in theory. So here you can see the Docker image has been built. Now we'll say Docker compose and Docker compose, and then we wanna say up. Now it's gonna bring up all the three containers together, Nginx, Redis, and WSGI and your Flask. All right, let's go to the foo route, the production IP route. Localhost slash foo, no ports, remember? Oops, not do, I should say localhost, I would say slash foo. So here you can see message okay, Redis okay. So Redis is working, WSGI is working. So if you observe here, it's creating multiple threads. So of our Flask application, here you can see. So it's pretty fast. It's pretty efficient. It's one of the best things. You have unit test, you have Redis, you have WSGI, Nginx routing. So here are the advantages. Your Flask API endpoints are not directly exposed. It's basically hiding behind a WSGI gateway. So it's more secure. All the load balancing is done by Nginx. So it's more best approach. So I would recommend anyone to use this architecture, this way of approach for Flask if you're doing any kind of REST APIs. I'm gonna leave all the links to the description section below. All the codes, all the folders, everything will be there on my GitHub. So you can go ahead and check it out, okay? So I hope you have enjoyed this tutorials, and if so, do give a like. And if you have any more questions, kindly list your questions in the comments, and would be very happy to assist you. Once again, thank you for love, support. See you in the next video. Goodbye.